Okay, what a pleasure to welcome you back from lunch. And I think a year ago when the Scientific Program Committee asked me and Tommy, you see, could you give an lecture about the history of ITI, we said, of course, it would be a pleasure. Although now in the last 10 days you have seen this has been a tremendous bunch of work.
That's right, yeah.
Okay, we talk Good. About the ITI history, but there is a second line there, and I think Tommy wants to talk about that as well.
Okay, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It is a great pleasure for me and also for Danny Bruce that you have the opportunity to give you a little overview about the ITI and his activities and how everything has started about 47 years ago. Who are the persons behind the ITI? What was the driving force to establish such an organization, and why has been the collaboration of ITI and Straumann over 5 decades so successful?
Yeah, you see, we have 5 decades, and it started in the early 70s.
This is right, yeah. Let's start in the early 70s, when the story of dental implants in our organization started. Straumann first contact with a group of clinicians which had several ideas of developing dental implants. This was André Schröder, Philipp Ledermann, Wilfried Schilly, and Giesbeck Krekeler. At this moment, let's welcome one of the very important persons behind the ITI. It is a great pleasure to give a special welcome to Professor Wilfried Schilly. Wilfried Schilly is one of the founding members, and after André Schröder, he became the second ITI president. Wilfried, it is a great honor that you are here with us today. So the first implants which has been developed were single and double hollow cylinders or baskets under the name of type C and E implants. These implants has been redesigned in the mid-70s. As a result, you can see the type F, K, and H implants were launched. In the same time, the first solid screw came to the market under the name of TPS. At this time, 2 philosophies were strongly in place. The Bern group, which preferred the hollow type implants, and the Freiburg group, which was focused on the solid implants. So Danny, you may probably explain a little bit more about the clinical aspects of these implants.
Yeah, I think what you see here are these original prototypes, and they're all one-piece implants, one piece. Abutment implant, same body, and you see the TPS surface goes all the way up to the neck. When I joined the ITI group, there was a heavy debate in the early 80s where that TPS surface should stop. Huh? And I think you are right. There were a lot of controversial discussions between these groups, and I think later on then we tried to solve this.
Okay,
good. I think same time, in 76, we all know this paper, landmark paper. I have to say, unfortunately, published in a Swiss dental journal in German language, so it needed some time to get recognized. But it was the first time in the scientific world that an implant was documented with osseointegration, direct bone-to-implant contact, because they had the histologic technique available to do these non-decalcified sections. I attended a conference in 81 where André showed this to Italian dentists, and they went completely bananas that this is possible, because at that time, blade implants were supposed to be surrounded by encapsulation with the distance and this fibrous encapsulation.
So we are in the 80s, and one of the most important milestones in our common history was decided. After an intensive period of developments with this group of clinicians and pioneers, my father and André Schröder came to the conclusion that a group of experts has to be established to support the further development of oral implantology. The model which has been used was the model of the AO-ASIF, which was founded in the 60s in the field of orthopedics and traumatology. Straumann was strongly involved in this organization at the time, and a lot of experience were transferred into this new organization, which was founded under the name of ITI. So you see the founding members here listed. There are a lot of famous names. Some of them barely passed away, but there are still a lot existing. So it was always the major goal that all activities between the ITI and Straumann were under the umbrella of friendship, fairness, and common understanding in a constructive surrounding to bring the field of oral implantology forward to the next level of innovation. In the first step, the ITI-TK, that was the technical commission, which became later than the ITI development committee, was established. The aim was to develop and test improved implants, prosthetic parts, instruments, and a lot of other products. So Danny, maybe you can explain a little bit about the first courses which took place in the same time.
Yeah, in Waldenburg were the so-called ITI Kurse. And I think I attended the first one in 1984. That was the sixth course. So they had twice a year. They had in Waldenburg clinical courses, including also Benny Maglin and the other famous names. And I think that was quite important to have it. And you see here the pioneers. I think that was the second ITI course in Waldenburg.
That was the second ITI course in Waldenburg in a brand new auditorium.
Yeah.
In 1985, Anders Schröder was asking the young Danny Boozer to join the group and to take this as an opportunity to create his future career. So look at Danny, especially the young dentist. You can do a lot within the ITI. So 1986, Danny joined the group and as I said, a career. And then in 86, the complete new ITI implant system was presented under the name of BoneFit, which you can see here. This was the time when Danny Boozer showed up the first time in this big game. And as everybody knows, he is still one of the game leaders until today. So Danny, I'm sure that you remember this time.
Perfect. Andre came to me and said, look, that's a chance for you. We have to stop this competition, so we try to include all these different shapes into one system. Solid screw, hollow cylinder, and the combination was a hollow screw. And we wanted to have it in two pieces, not a monocore, a two-piece implant that gives more flexibility. And then, as we know, and that was then presented inside ITI in 1986. And you see there the first ITI symposium, actually in Basel, across the street, in the Montreal room of the Congress Center with 500 people, where the Bernese group, the Freiburg group, presented then this to the colleagues. And that was the beginning, I think, of the rise then of Straumann.
Of the story.
Yes.
So let's go over to the ITI Foundation, Danny.
Yeah, also here you see the that was an association. And I remember there was once a year in August annual meeting, and there was in the, I think the finance was about 100,000 Swiss francs. And we wanted to have more money for research. And I met once Fritz Straumann and Andre Schröder actually in spring 1988 and asked him, look, we should have more money for research. And then he said, let's do a foundation. And they established a foundation in August 1988. Fritz gave actually almost 1 million Swiss francs from another bank account into that too as a starting capital. And I think what you see there, that's the strong belief of these two really very important persons for the ITI. So the statement by Andre Schröder always has been, and it has been shown many times, and I really stress to the young friends here who want to do research to read that very carefully. I think it's very important. Scientific approach, he says, research has to be independent, free and open to discussion, and should not be paid, so then you don't have the chance to analyze the data with freedom, you see. And I think that is very important.
Same to my father. He was very dedicated to research and development. So I can't read around the corner, so I have to stay here. One of his statements was, to ensure future success, extensive research and training must always precede the market introduction of new products. I think that's very important. That's something what Straumann still stands behind today.
Yeah, it's actually the basis of evidence-based dental medicine.
Absolutely.
I think that's very important. Okay. Then the shock. I mean, everybody remembers those days. The contract was signed on Friday afternoon, and on Tuesday, Fritz Straumann had a heart attack and passed away. And I can tell you the idea was in complete shock. And of course, Straumann, I'm sure, same for the family. How did you experience? Then I saw him the first time at the funeral.
That's
young Tommy.
That's right, yeah.
That was a tough day, huh?
That was a tough day, yeah. And that was the time when another big milestone in the common history was decided. Because after the death of my father in 88, our family decided to make some fundamental changes within the family business. At this time, the main part of the Straumann business, the activities of orthopedics and traumatology, have been sold through a management buyout. So this business was continuing under the name of Stratec Medical under the new ownership of Rudy Mark. He was one of the managing directors at the time before with Straumann. So I personally decided to take the dental part of the company out of this deal and put it into a new company, which I founded again under the name of Straumann. So there was a little bit, it was a little bit unclear at the beginning, but it was just after a few months, it was clear what we want to do. So at the same time, IDI had around 40 members. So the membership was limited to 40. And the new Straumann company had around 45 employees. From this moment on, the success of growth, the growth story of ITI and Straumann began. And I know exactly that at this time, many people didn't believe in us. But when I look back, let's say, I can say we showed them how to do it. Quite easy.
Yes. So the 1990s was then a broadening of the focus from the development committee, and we started to move into education. The responsibility was passed on from André Schroeder to Wilfried Chili, as you can see, later on then to Klaus Lang. And you see, activities started it very nicely. First consensus conference, first reorganization, and large world symposia in this decade. The first very important step was a strategy meeting in Rheinfelden.
Yes.
At the Rhine. And I think there the structure has been rediscussed and we reorganized the organization.
So it was the first reorganization of the ITI and we made a lot of really important decisions for the future, for the growing of the ITI. So at this time, the ITI was still organized with two legal organizations, the ITI Association with its development committee and the ITI, and the education committee, sorry, and the ITI Foundation, which was focused on research. So under the new organization, the three committees has been centralized under the lead of board of directors, as you can see on this organization chart. The ITI Foundation became, after this reorganization, more the financial body of the ITI. It's still the same structure today. Another important decision was also one of the founding members sitting here in the front row, that's Walter Widmer. In the same time, the ITI Center was established, and Walter Widmer was the founder and the first head of the ITI Center for many years. And as everybody knows, he was the driving person in front and behind the curtain. He organized not only different kinds of symposias, he organized consensus conferences, the whole administrative organization of the ITI, and many things. Again, a big job.
Yeah, and this 93, this is some pictures we have found. You can see Audrey was there, Wilfried, of course. And you see that the collaboration was very... We let the Straumann guys do the work and we gave them the wisdom. No, of course, it's just as you see. But, and we also had the chance, as usual, you see, we had nice dinners and just enjoyed the friendship between the different members. So 93 was also the first consensus conference in German language, and it had no literature review. We just exchanged clinical experience, and their very important decision was made that the main implant shape should be the solid screw. Because we have seen the need that we should have this screw then in a smaller version, a larger version, wide screw, wide neck, and that opened the door for this development. And I think in 95, then this process was finished, and since then, the Straumann implants are made of solid screws.
I remember exactly this day because that was really hard for Straumann, and I was in the driving seat at this time, and they just kicked out our hollow screws. So that was it was quite a sales driver. But I think everything came right.
Absolutely. No, I think we have had data at that time, and both, it was published later, 8-year data. The solid screws had about 97% safe security or success rates, and the hollow screw about 2% less, and the hollow cylinder was the worst with about 5% less success rate, and therefore the decision was absolutely right and based on evidence.
Absolutely.
Okay. Then actually we also expanded in our educational efforts. The ITI World Symposium was first held in the United States in Washington. Hilton Hotel, those who have been there, they remember that they forced us out because Bill Clinton came to this hotel at 6 o'clock for a speech. And then of course all the bodyguards moved in and kicked us out, you see. Congress was very nice, 800 people. And I think it was a very nice experience.
That was very important also to Straumann because from the 90s on, we really concentrated on the US market, and this first symposium was very, very important to us to present the company and to present the system and the ITI in the US.
Yeah. 97, the second consensus conference, the first one in English language, and the first one where we also did a little bit literature analysis, although not systematic reviews. But it was a very nice conference. You see that the president changed. Wilfried Schilly, after 5 years, stepped down, and Klaus Lang took over. And you see here the ITI board and the foundation board, because there were two boards together, and quite a large group. And I think we all remember those days, because during that conference, Lady Di was killed in a car accident, and that was the talk of the town. Of course, on Saturday morning. We decided there to have a scholarship program. Jürting Hansen, Eric was very instrumental in that one. And today I can say this is a fantastic program. This morning we have seen so many former ITI scholars performing at top, top level. And you can see it was decided in 97. Then the first ones were given 98. The first scholar who made it into the board of ITI is Lisa Heitz Mayfield. She was an ITI scholar in Bern in the early 2000s. And you see the program developed fantastic, and the ITI spends on average about $1 million Swiss franc to support these top-notch young colleagues. So here you see how many stipends ITI has given away, and a total of almost 14 million Swiss francs in all the years. Okay, then the millennium change, 2000.
2000, yeah.
Yes. So here you see again the four presidents involved in this decade. You see again a reorganization and then very important moves in terms of education. And when we go through that systematically, I think this is the change in the reorganization. And this was based on a request also from Straumann to open the membership. Huge discussions was in Zurich, actually, in the Hotel Widder. But we found a very good agreement because at the end, everybody was happy.
Yeah, I think that was really a very, very important decision to Straumann to open the membership to ITI fellows and members and to establish also the sections, the ITI sections. This was absolutely needed because of the strong growth of Straumann in the different kind of region, and the aim was to to grow parallelly, IGI and Straumann, that IGI has to be present in the markets where Straumann has been present and so on. So that was really important.
Everything was under the umbrella of the foundation now, and we made a new logo. I remember that about 2003. And we said in the beginning, when we were probably down here, very small, and now ITI has grown up and we might be somewhere here. Because there we had 300 members, and now we have 17,000, the largest in the world. And I think that's a very nice logo to document the drive and the development of the organization. This is then in Gstaad, that is then the subsequent year where the constitution has been adapted. It was also a consensus conference, almost 100 participants, and the first time that we have done systematic reviews. Some of the top topics were initiated there: loading protocols, post-extraction implant placement. Very important papers came out of this. And you see that the structure has been adapted with three committees and a scholarship subcommittee. Development of sections.
You can see very steep growth of the sections, as I said before, in parallel with Straumann, expansion of the markets. So this is really important and still growing today. And we are very happy on that.
Yeah, we still have 27 sections right now, but it might be that soon, what I hear from the board, they're going to add now additional sections in certain important areas where we need this. Okay, very important project, ITI treatment guidelines. You see, ITI treatment guide was discussed for about 2 years, came out in 2007. And you see here, that is, I think, the first one, implant therapy in the aesthetic zone. And we wanted to provide our peers, you see, like cookbook-style recommendations, which is based on evidence. So the first part of the book is always the analysis of the literature, and then the recommendation, and then case reports. And you see now we have had a beautiful series. Almost every year a book came out. Today this book is translated into 10 languages. Man, that's amazing, amazing achievement. And when you click the next one, then you see actually the upcoming. This is coming out, a jubilee, you can say, number 10. And it's coming out in about 4 weeks. You can have a look at it at Quintessence booth. It is the same topic as here. So it's just an update on single tooth, aesthetic single tooth replacement. It's a fabulous book. I really have to say, we have been reading the three editors, not for weeks, but for nights, to get through these damn manuscripts. And it's a very nice book. So we can be very proud for this achievement. That's no question. Then we were forced, I have to say, by certain strong people that it's time to think about a strategy. And we organized in Fitznau again, the same hotel as before, a strategy meeting. You see here the board and a few additional members. And we defined the ITI Vision 2017. That was very important for the upcoming years then, because we were working hard then to achieve these goals. And I think most of them we achieved very nicely. But this meeting was very important because it gave us a sense that we have to be open for changes and we have to follow a certain strategy. And so during my presidency, that was always at the wall, you see, when we had a discussion, said, are we following our vision here, the strategy, or is it actually against the strategy? So that was installed in 2008. That was then really more than 100 colleagues in Stuttgart, hometown of Dieter Weingart. All these changes were made under his leadership. And you see that we have adapted, again, the structure, one additional committee. And most important, we, after a really long phase of examination, we have been lucky to get Friedrich Buch as our executive director. When I look back, I mean, that's almost 10 years now, this has been a really wise decision. We have seen about 20 candidates. with a very famous headhunter in Switzerland. We paid tons of money for that, but every money was well spent because that's the guy who helped us to achieve our goals.
So at the same meeting in 2008, the board decided to remove the ITI Development Committee from its organization. So during these 28 years when the Development Committee existed, around 2,000 products, it's a huge number, have been discussed, tested, and approved. So from then on, the ITI fellows and clinicians were directly involved into product development projects within Straumann. This gave us the chance to speed up the development process and to work a little bit more efficiently.
Yes, in that decade, ITI further developed with the ITI World Symposium, you see. We came back to Lucerne, where the president of Switzerland made the opening speech, patient of Urs Belzer and mine, very famous politician, Adolf Ogi. Then we went to the States, San Diego. We went to a really nice place in Munich, in Germany, and then back to New York. And you see the numbers of participants grew over the years, reflecting that we had more and more members in the organization. Very nice memories to all these.
Great symposiums.
And then we entered the decade, the current one. And here now you see, these are the three presidents involved, that when you go through the line here, then this is mostly educational business. Education clearly became our number one focus because there's a huge need in the field. We all know that. We see a lot of bad treatments, and these colleagues need to be educated. And I would say ITI grew into the largest global educational provider in the field of implant dentistry. It's an educational powerhouse today. And we go through these various steps. Of course, the Study Club helped us tremendously to grow, because that was a return of investment for a member. You see that he could go four times to a Study Club meeting, small, cozy atmosphere, with more experienced people, to showcase, to learn from the better ones. And when we see how we developed this Study Club concept in no time, up to 600 around the globe, and now we are at a constant high level, I think we can be very proud. This is really a nice setup. It was established then in 2011 at the AGM in Barcelona. That's the board then. And you see then for a certain period, we had even six committees, one also for the study clubs to do that build-up and for the sections and so on. As you will see later now, ITI board has again reduced the number of committees since we have to adapt to the current situation from time to time. ITI Consensus Conference in my hometown, when then the presidency has been shifted over to David Cochrane, my long-term friend, was an easy one. And at that time, it was also decided that then his successor will be Stephen Chen. So we have really excellent consistency in the leadership, and the conference has been very nice, very successful. This is David's main project. That is the introduction of the ITI Online Academy. And it's amazing what you can get on that platform. This is a wealth of knowledge available. And I'm looking forward to the time point that the board will make a decision that when you're an ITI member, this is all free of charge. That has to come in the future, because it's already decided? Okay. Because that is then the return of investment to be an ITI member. We should not make money out of our educational efforts. See, that's not our job for the foundation. The dividends we have is the better quality in the field. That's our dividends and the camaraderie, as we will come later. So this is an excellent platform. It has a lot of information on it, consensus database, and most recently now also a certain these classrooms, universities have that. You can click, and this is the success they have, you see. Thomas Kisch is the driving force from the headquarters, and he gave me these numbers, and you can see when you looked at every day, they have now more than 500 colleagues working on a session. They will have this year more than 1 million page views on that homepage. I mean, that's tremendous. It shows the need for this kind of education. And we will hear later on this during the symposium that this is not the end. The next step is already in front of us. And that is then the big project of Stephen Chen. Now, this we cannot really comment.
No, we haven't part of that.
This is the ITI board in December 2015. To go back like what we did in FITS now to discuss where are we in 5 years. And the result, as you will not see, but we will explain it a little bit, was then that they established the vision, ITI vision 2020, 5 years later. And this has been approved at the last AGM in Chicago, and this is now where ITI moves. And I heard in the board when they have meetings, the Vision 2020 is again at the wall to see that they stick to this strategy they have decided on. And I think that's how you have to do it. So the structure has been adapted, a little bit streamlined, so the study club committee was integrated into education, for example. So this is a little bit easier to handle.
So a few words to the ITI symposiums. You can see nicely, we growed constantly since 2010 in Geneva, now 2017 in Basel. These are around close to 1,000 more participants. So this shows, I mean, exactly that the ITI is becoming more and more attractive to young generation and young clinicians. And I think that's what we have to work on.
Yeah. So when we discuss now, where are we now? You see, after almost 40 years of collaboration, I think ITI is the largest association, is a powerhouse in education. That's the main activity, and we continue to be the largest private research fund provider. And it has to be like this. Through the research support, we get all the bright young guys into the ITI. It helps to drive the development and the knowledge, and we get young people into the system. That's very important.
Yeah, and the role of Straumann, I think our part of this collaboration is we are developing and selling products for implant therapy in high quality. The Swiss quality, okay, I mean, that has to be normal today, but it isn't, as we know. So these are really our high standards, high quality, high level. And to support the ITI with annual contributions that the ITI can fulfill the activities in research and education.
Okay, you see the development of membership. Here we opened up, and then you see we have had here the study clubs. Gave then, and now we are somewhere between 15, 16, 17,000 members. And the composition, very important, that we have a lot of young members, junior members, as we call them.
So there's a really steep increase of members, and what is really nice to say that is from January this year until today, these are only 5 months, 1,700 new members, and mostly junior members, joined the ITI. That's a huge number, and it confirms exactly what I've said before. The ITI is becoming more and more attractive, and I think we really have to focus on that.
Yeah. Research support, I don't have to discuss the numbers. You see here constant with the growth, and when you see the total, give the next, then you see 465 grants since its inception in 1988 and almost 50 million Swiss francs. Many here had the pleasure to have an accepted grant, and this is a stimulation, and it's highly regarded because it's a competitive grant. You have to fight with others, and only those with a good quality will succeed. And also research award by André Schröder, in memory of André Schröder, I think for a lot of young people, very important. You see our first recipient here, 92, and here you see another one. This is Alexander Benecke at the Lucerne meeting, and here you see the names of all the recipients. I think it's a big stimulus.
So So once more, the symposium, 1988, we started in Basel, 2070, we are back in Basel, and the first World Symposium, as it named World Symposium, 95 in Washington, and you can see the number of participants is constantly increasing.
Yeah. Now we come to the money.
Yes, exactly, the money. Money is crucial. So the graphic shows constantly increase of the contributions from Straumann until 2012. In 2012, the board of directors decided that the contribution from Straumann should be below 50% of the total income of the ITI. This does not mean that the overall income of the ITI was decreased. It was more a shift to other income resources. So if we add, for example, the income from education or membership fees, the total income of the ITI is more or less on the same level than 2012 or even higher. So Danny, maybe you can explain a little bit the other side of the pie.
I think that's important that ITI generates its own money, because otherwise we get under pressure from certain people. And you can also see that we spend a lot of, most of the money we spend for membership, education at all levels, then research, of course, and we also have about 20% administration, because we need that. We have about 20 employees in Basel. I mean, for 17,000 members, you need a good office, and they are very good, and I think that's important.
So ITI is a big family. ITI is fun. We had a lot of really funny experiences together in different kind of countries. Let's say, sorry, I'm a little bit too fast.
Too fast,
much too fast.
Yeah, okay. Before we go to the fun part, and that's only then for about 3 minutes, I think it's important to acknowledge those who have been instrumental, and this is actually the Hall of Fame of ITI honorary fellows. And interestingly, we missed to give this to André Schröder. We gave him a prize, the Schröder Award. But you see here, in all the years, and now we are waiting to get the first female ITI honorary fellow. So this is an appetizing for all the females we have, and we have now very active females in the organization. That is just a matter of time.
Yeah, it is.
It just reflects how it was.
Yeah.
And now we come to the fun part. And some of you might be a little bit nervous about that, because we were looking for really funny pictures. And we just let it run. That should show, you see the friendship between Bern and Freiburg. See, and you see now here all images from AGMs. This is, for example, 97. And this is one in Basel in the mid-90s, early 90s. But you see everywhere happy faces. These are the AGM dinners. Lots often with music. We had once Hasi Ostwald, very famous Swiss jazz musician. And it stops here with young Tommy. And then, of course, legendary, the Japanese and the Korean ITI congresses. This is the first one in 85. And here, look here, late 90s, early 2000s, with Nakashima, and the very special people, you see. Yeah. Says everything. And here, then the last one we had was like this. That, you have to press now. That is in 2000. Pavarotti. Honestly, we have had evenings unbelievable. This scene, everybody remembers who was in that room, and that's 10 years ago. Okay, now look this one. That's 1998. This is Moulin Rouge ladies coming to Bern, and in a very famous There is even a videotape, but it has been destroyed by somebody to eliminate the evidence. Huh? And then we also had a lot of golf and sports activities many times. When I look in the last 5 years, I'm missing a little bit these social events at AGMs, and I told Danny Wismeyer in Amsterdam, we need to have an evening like this, because that's so important for the team spirit and for the memory. You see, we played many times golf, of course, and here's his a bike tour in Switzerland, and after 3 minutes, Tom Taylor had already almost a broken leg, because it was an e-bike. Okay.
No, I think that's really right what you're saying. That's so important to have the social side of the ITI, which underline the family feeling, the family spirit of this organization. And I think that's also something which we have to reactivate a little bit more in the future.
Now, when we look into the future, we also made a conclusion slide from the ITI side. I would say we should maintain the drive and the energy to be the leader in implant education. That's very important. Maintain this exceptional team spirit in the ITI, really work on it. Integrate the youngsters, most important, and we do that very well, I would say, these days, since they are our future. We should stick to the scientific principles of evidence-based dental medicine, but at the same time, we have to stay open for the challenges and for the changes ahead of us, you see. So we have to find the balance between the two aspects.
So my conclusions are that this model of a close partnership between these two organizations showed us that collaboration between science, clinic, and industry can work perfectly. And it is absolutely crucial that both organizations have to develop their strategies in parallel, otherwise we are going different ways. ITI has to be open-minded for today's and tomorrow's challenges, and there are a lot of challenges which are coming in front of us, science-wise, market-wise, and customer-wise. And Straumann has to accept scientific standards and protocols and guidelines of the ITI for the entire activities which have to be done in the future. So this is also something which came from the very past, and I said we are still stand behind that. So at the very end, both organizations will head on to the same target. We all would like to be the signpost of the golden standard in implantology and related fields. To be that, we have to continue our partnership with trust in a friendly way and common understanding, as always did in the past, in terms of our patients. And this brings us to the end of this presentation.
Yeah.
40 years.
I would say the future ahead of us is bright. We should always, as you just said so elegantly, continue this collaboration. We will soon celebrate 40 years of ITI, that's in 2020. It will be combined with an ITI World Symposium, of course, that has been planned already 10 years ago. And with that, I think we thank you so much for your attention. We apologize that we went overboard, but that we could envision that with so many slides, but the memories have been overwhelming.
Thank you very much. Thank you.